Hello, everyone. Here we are to do the third page of the morning work section in the week three packet. Up at the top, you'll see it says morning work 8.1. So now we have been having all subtraction problems, but now they are mixing addition and subtraction. So what we need to do is now we've got some of those tricky ones where the first number is missing, but we got to pay attention because this is an addition fact. So I know that when I have a number and I add 5, it will give me 12. Well, I need to kind of do the opposite of what I did for the subtraction facts. I know my sum is 12, but to find out what number I added 5 to, I need to do the opposite. Instead of adding that 5, I need to take it away. So I know if I have 12 and I take away 5, that will give me 7. So I'm gonna put 7 here, and then I can say 7 plus 5 equals 12. Or another strategy is you could start at 5, count up to 12 either on your number grid or a number line that you draw, and however many jumps you have to make, that will be the number that's missing, okay? Now, this is a subtraction one. Now, I know that 7 plus 5 was 12. Well, now I have something minus 5 equals 7. I see a 5 and a 7 just like I had up here. So let's think about our backwards strategy. I have 7. I'm going to add back those 5 that I took away. 7 plus 5. Oh, wait a minute. Hey, up here, it told me it's 12. So let's give this a try. Let's put 12 in there. 12 minus 5 equals 7. Okay, so take a look at these ones. Now, these two have missing numbers in the middle. So 16 minus something is going to give me 9. Again, if you need a number grid or a number line to help you, you can draw that or print one off if you don't have the one in your folder. So now we have 9 plus something equals 16. Think about it. There's a lot of the same numbers here. Think about those number families we've worked with. And here I have blank plus 2 equals 6. You could use that backwards strategy. But remember, if it's addition, I need to take away that number to figure out what I started with. Or you can start at this number, count up to that, and however many jumps you had to do to count up will be your answer. Okay, so give the rest of those a try. Now, we need to write the numbers in order form. We've got 58, 61, and 41. So the smallest number will go here. Well, which of these is the smallest number? Well, I have a 5 in the tens place, a 6 in the tens place, and a 4 in the tens place. Well, that tells me what I need to know. That 4 in the tens place is the smallest. So I'm going to put 41 here. Now, look at your other two numbers. What would be the next one? And then what would be the greatest or the biggest number? I'll have you finish that one up by yourself. Now, Dora has 27 stickers. Anna has 72. And Shane has 43 stickers. Put the names in order from who has the most stickers to the least. Now here, you're not putting the numbers, you're putting the names. So they want you to start with the greatest or the biggest. Well, Dora has 27, Anna has 72, Shane has 43. Well, I've got a 2 in the tens place, a 7 in the tens place, and a 4. Well, I'm gonna go with that 7. Now, remember, I'm not writing the number, I'm writing the name. It's Anna that has 72. So I'm gonna write Anna's name here. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna cross her out because I know I've already used that one. So you guys go ahead and do the next one. Who has the next most and then who has the least or the smallest number? Okay, down here, ABC order, we've got two sets of words. Remember, you look at your first letter, see which comes first in the alphabet. If they have the same first letter, you look at your second letter. If they have the same second letter, you look at your third letter. So we've got circle, race, city, center. And then over here, we've got popcorn, came, factory, cracker. I'm going to have you guys give those a try on your own, and then we'll go over them when we go over the answers. So, who clicked a picture of the bird? Somebody's asking a question. So when I look at my words, let's take read through them. We've got picture, Grace, a canary with a period, took the recently cute of. Well, I know my sentence has to start with a capital letter. The only word that has a capital letter here is this name of Grace. So I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to write Grace, and then I'll cross it out. I'm going to have you go ahead, give the rest of the sentence a try. If you're not sure, just go ahead and wait till we go over the answers, and you can fill it in. So again, if you have any issues or you're not sure what to do, just skip over it and you can fill it in when we go over the answers. I'm going to have you pause the video now to do your work, give everything your best shot, and then we'll go over the answers in just a moment. Okay, and here we go to go over the answers. Now, we did these first two together, so let's take a look at these middle ones. I know that 16 minus 7 equals 9. Well, when I look down here, I'm looking for a sum of 16. Well, if 16 minus 7 gave me 9, then I know that 9 plus 7 will give me 16. So it's kind of like a fact family there. Same over here. I know, now, if you look, I had to cross something out because I was not paying attention and I did 6 plus 2 equals 8. That's not right. So I had a number. So if I have 6, I'm going to take away that 2 and that gives me 4. And I also know my fact families that 4 plus 2 is 6. Well, if 4 plus 2 equals 6, then I know that 6 minus 2 must equal that 4 that I found up there. Down here, we've discovered that 41 was the smallest number by looking in our tens places. I know I've got a 5 and a 6 in my tens place, so I know 58 will come next and 61 will be the greatest. We had something similar here, but instead of the numbers, we needed the names. So we figured that Anna had the, now they wanted us to go from greatest to least here. Anna had 72, which was the greatest. Then I looked, Dora had 27 and Shane had 43. Well, I know 43 is bigger than 27, so I wrote Shane's name here, and so then I know Dora would have the least with there. In our ABC order, I had 3 words that began with the letter C. So I know since they all began with C, I needed to look at the second letter. Well, I had an E and 2 I's. So I know E comes before I, so I knew center was my first word. So then here I had C-I and C-I. Well, then I look at my third letter, C-I-R, C-I-T. Well, I know R comes before T in the alphabet, so I know circle went next, then city, and then my last word was race. Over here, I had 2 words that began with C. Well, one was C-A, one was C-R. So I know A comes before R, so I knew that came went first, then cracker. Then I know that F comes before P, so it was factory and popcorn. Then down here at the bottom, it was who clicked a picture of the bird. Well, we discovered that Grace was the first word because it's the only word that had a capital letter. So Grace recently took a picture of the cute canary. I know that canary goes last because it had the period there. So here are our answers for Morning Work 8.1, which is the third morning worksheet in our week 2 packet. Awesome job, everybody.